Hey guys, welcome to the channel. As you see in the thumbnail, what if Touma was in high school DxD part 5. Hope you like it and please do subscribe and comment if you want part 6. Chapter 5 fixed. I do not own high school DxD or Toru Majutsu no index. Author's note. I'm sorry for not updating for so long. I just had writer's block disease, so here's the chapter you all been asking for. Enjoy. The sword that he recognizes is from the person who bumped into him the other night. Wait, you're that person from the other night. And you're that boy who caught Excalibur. She turned to him but quickly turns around and blocks one of the light spears. Fools, just because you have a shard of Excalibur doesn't mean you can defeat me. He shouted while forming another spear. Touma saw his chance and dashed towards the magic circle, imbecile. Kakabal yelled out and threw his incomplete spear at Touma just as he pulled his hand away, destroying the circle. As soon as he destroyed it, all of the Cerberuses stopped fighting, and turned to Touma and blew a wall of fire on top of Touma, protecting him. Touma covered his face but looked at the wall of flames and turned to Cerberus, who appeared behind him. You have my thanks, King of all Dragons Ashscale. Cerberus then dove into the hole along with the other Cerberus, and the hole closed as they all entered. What? King of Dragons Ashscale. Touma was stuck in thought and didn't notice the sharp blade slashing down his back. But as he turns to the coming sword, Kiba appears right in front of him, blocking Freed. Kiba, Touma said in surprise, and just as he yelled his name, Freed threw Kiba towards Touma, making them fall to the ground. Freed, what took you so long? Kakabal said while looking down at him somewhat relieved. Well, I was escorting this guy. Freed turned his gaze to an old fat man dressed in white church clothing. Fine, now since you're here, destroy them, he commanded Freed, and he gladly bowed to everyone. Hello shitty devils, I'll be your executioner today. Now let's start with you three. He pointed his sword at Touma, Kiba, and Zenovia. Then come, I will avenge my fallen friends when I destroy that sword. Kiba and Zenovia charged at Freed with swords drawn. Oh my, this'll be a fucking fun fight. He then held the sword with both of his hands and concentrated, emitting a light orange glow of some kind on the sword. Come on shitting devils. He then raised it up in the air and brung it downwards, creating a large energy that cutted the ground and created a large dust cloud, stopping Kiba and Zenovia. As the dust cleared, Kiba and Zenovia looked at Freed but found him nowhere, looking for me. Kiba looks upwards and sees him falling down atop of him with the tip aimed at his face. Kiba rolls to the side and lets Freed stab the ground. With Freed looking for Kiba, Zenovia comes in and throws one swipe of her Excalibur shard at Freed, but Freed punches her in her stomach, throwing her back. Die bitch. He raised his weapon up above her and was about to bring down at her, but Kiba attacked him from behind. Oh, looks like this shitty devil still wants to fight me. Freed and Kiba's sword were now in a deadlock. Shut up. Kiba forced him away and thrust it at Freed, making a small cut on his side. Freed backs away from him and looks at his sides and put his hand over the cut and pulls it into view. You shitty devil. Freed then concentrates on his sword and the same aura formed around it but was much more larger, and he threw his attack at Kiba, launching the mass of power at him. Kiba blocked the attack with sword birth and his own weapon, but he was blown away and landed on the ground and saw Valper smiling, and approaches him. Kiba, you are a fool to think you can destroy the holy sword Excalibur. He then laughed at Kiba, and within Kiba he wanted to cry in despair, but he soon stood back up with his determination. Shut up, you killed all of my friends. Kiba then walked towards him slowly but stopped as Valper took out a small blue crystal and tosses it to him. Kiba caught the crystal and examined it. What is this? You are holding your friends in your hand, a pity that they all turned to stone after you left, he began to grin. Kiba on the other hand fell to the ground and clenched it, crying, everyone. Valper soon looked at Freed, signaling him to kill Kiba. You had your tearful reunion, now die you shit. Freed slammed his blade down on Kiba, but Freed was thrown to the side by Touma. Kiba looked up to Touma and saw a hand extend to him. Come on Kiba, you still haven't fulfilled your friend's wishes. Kiba held Tuma's hand and he was pulled to his feet with a confused face. What do you mean Touma? Keep holding onto the crystal and concentrate on it. Touma then turned to Freed, who stood back up. You little shit. Freed launched himself at them but was thrown back by a gust of wind. As Touma looks at Kiba, he saw children young and older standing around Kiba, glowing gently. Everyone, I'm sorry I couldn't avenge you all. Kiba then looked down at the ground, disappointed at himself, but he soon saw a little girl run up to him. It's all right Kiba, ghost kid. We wanted you to live, ghost kid. Live for us, ghost kid. Stay strong and you'll win, ghost kid. You aren't alone, ghost kid. We'll always be one, ghost kid. Kiba then turned to Touma and saw a grin on his face. Thank you, Touma. Thank you, everyone. Kiba then closed his eyes and a black energy emerged from his body along with a white energy flying upwards and merging together. What? Impossible. Dark energy and light energy should be repelling each other, not combining. Hehehe, I see. The only way that darkness and light will combine is. Valper stopped talking when a spear of light pierced through his body. Now that you fulfilled your uses, you are now worthless. Valper then fell to the ground and the spear disappeared. In Kiba's hand was a sword shining with a black blade and gray-colored handle. So what, you got a sword? Big whoop, now are you going to fight me? Freed then held Excalibur up in the air, ready to throw another powerful attack but was stopped by a sword flying at him. Freed stepped back and the sword slammed into the ground and created a large quake, forcing everyone to fall to the ground, but soon stopped as Freed held it in his left hand. Ha ha ha, another one for the collection. Freed then threw down the devastating slash but was countered by another slash, but that one was the color of aqua. What? Zenovia holds the sword at the ready in front of Kiba, and Touma, Freed of the Fallen Angels, you are hereby judged by God. Oh, and what are you going to do? Freed taunted her, and began to get into his stance, but jumped away from his spot. He looked back and saw Kiba there. You little shit, you gave me a scare. Freed laughed maniacally and stared back at Kiba. That wasn't all I gave you. Freed then felt pain on his left arm. As he turned to it, he saw a medium-sized cut across his arm. Now you're going to get it. Freed threw himself at Kiba, but just as he got halfway, Zenovia slashed downwards on his neck but blocked his sword. Now don't get hasty. Just as he was about to swing his left hand at Zenovia, Kiba slammed his blade with the Excalibur fragment, destroying it. Freed stared at his shattered weapon. He then showed a face filled with anger and hate. You fucking piece of shit. He kicked Zenovia away and he brung his sword around and thrusted it at Kiba's face. Kiba didn't run or hesitate, but he thrusted his own blade under Freed's sword, causing sparks to fly along with a tiny light. As the blade reached Freed's hand, Kiba twists his sword and cuts some of his fingers, but he still held onto the sword. Ah. Freed then backed away from Kiba and stared at his hand. He then chuckled to himself, hehehehehehe, now I'm pissed. Freed then uses his left hand and pulls a gun inside of his coat. Go back to hell. He then pulled the trigger, firing a yellow light that struck Kiba leg. He fell to the ground but planted his sword down in the ground. Freed then fired more rounds at Kiba while walking towards him, grinning. As he got closer to Kiba, he kicked the sword away from Kiba. He fell down on the ground and looks up to Freed. Die, you shitty fuck face. He then raised Excalibur up in the air with both of his hands and brung it down upon Kiba. Desperate, Kiba used his ability Sword Birth. If I time it right, I'll stop him from killing me. But as Kiba tries to activate Sword Birth, it doesn't appear. What? Now seeing his death, Kiba throws his arm up, trying to stop the blade from slicing him. Disappear to nothing. The sword slammed right into Kiba's shoulder, and Freed smiled with joy, waiting for the blood to gush out, but to his surprise, the sword turned black and into nothing. What the fuck just happened? Freed backed away from Kiba thinking he did it, but spots Touma behind him, wielding a black gauntlet almost similar to Issy's. What is that sacred gear? Kakabal yelled out in surprise and shock, but behind all that, he began to think about the power of the ability Touma showed. Hey, you know it's not good to kill, you know that, right? Touma then began to walk towards Freed, who pulled a second gun from under his coat. Oh, are you still mad about that one idiot who worked for the church? Well, not really, but who cares? He shot Touma a couple of times, but the projectiles didn't appear. Hey, don't tell me I forgot to fill this up. Looked inside of the barrel and then looked back at Touma, who was still walking towards him slowly. Oh, do I always have to use a sword to kill someone? He smiled to himself and stared at Touma while pulling out a handle that turned into a sword that glowed yellow. What do you care? Oh, are you still mad about me killing your friend? He jumped towards Touma and thrusted his weapon at him, but as it got closer to his body, it turned black then disappeared into nothing. Touma then threw a punch at Freed, throwing him to the ground. Hehe, come on, do it, finish it. Freed pressured him but failed. I'm not a taker of lives. He then walks away from Freed, towards Kiba. He held his hand to Kiba and he gladly held on while Touma pulled him on his feet, but just as he touches Touma, he feels a slight tingling all over his body. Kiba then held onto his left shoulder and hopped with Touma, who just walked towards Issei and Asia. Whistling asterisk. Touma turned around and held his right hand at the projectile. It then faded away. Everyone then turned to Kakabal, who was grinning to himself while up in the air. That is a truly interesting sacred gear. He stared at Touma's fearless eyes and the black gauntlet on his arm, that shined by itself. Kakabal, you lose my brother. Lord Satan should be here by now, so surrender. Rias commanded him, but he laughed out loud, saying something about God and death. Just by those words, the group of students became interested by what he said. What did you say about God and death? Kokakabal then looked at Rias and said, oh my, I didn't want it to slip, but oh well, the two factions lost their leaders, right? Well, what if I told you all that God died too after the war ended? They all became shocked by the news, he said, but Touma wasn't fazed by it. Then, why do our prayers still work? Asia meekly questioned him along with Zenovia. Looks like Michael is doing a great job being his replacement. Zenovia and Asia then fell to their knees after hearing what he said. Oh, did you two lost faith now that I told you? Ahaha, and I must admit it's funny to see your faces like that, even you, Ms. Grimori, he smiled to himself, seeing her face filled with frustration. After all, you are the only one who can beat me here, along with the help of your pawn who wields the booster gear. Issei then looks at Rias and sees her hand clenching into a fist. Issei then ran over to her side and whispered to her, Prez, you don't have to fight. No, I have to, Issei. If I don't, then he'll destroy this city. No, he'll start another war. Rias then walked towards Kakabal, ready with determination. But just as she took her first step, Issei held her hand and walked with her. If you want to, then we both go together, he smiled while happy he was holding her hand and fighting with her. The group of students all stared at the two walking towards their fight as if it was their last boost. The gauntlet yelled out every 10 seconds. As they approached him, they both stopped and the gauntlet yelled out, transfer. Rias and Issei then jumped upwards, throwing an attack, hoping to stop him. Kakabal wings covered him into a ball and blocks both of their attacks. He then opens up and launches two spears at them. Issei moved his left arm in front of the spear, blocking it, while Rias held a dark red orb that destroyed the spear aimed for her. Interesting. Kakabal then pushed the two away and threw more spears at them. Issei saw the incoming spears and quickly deflected them off with his gauntlet. He then landed on his back, sending a shock of pain throughout his body, and as that happened, Kakabal saw his chance and he threw his spears at Issei, but Rias appeared in front of him and swiped her hand in the air, sending a sheet of dark red energy, destroying the spears. Rias then pulled Issei off the ground and fought back, but just as they headed straight towards Kakabal, two spears flew at them, each aimed for their hearts. What? Rias thought only that and prepared for the impact and pain from the light spear, but as she prepared for the spear to hit her, she then felt a hand press against her breast and then something warm on her face. She then turned to her left and saw Issei ahead of her, and as she looked at his body, she saw the spear pierce through his back all the way. She then looked at the arm in front of her and saw his left hand holding the light spear, transfer. The booster gear yelled out and Rias felt power surge through her. She ignored the power transfer and concentrated on Issei. The end.